Today we're having our thesis Mao jacket exhibition. We've all constructed a Mao jacket out of an unconventional material to explore the properties of craft and materiality. So we're looking at more of kind of the systems and the connections between different materials, just like a building would as well.
The Mao jacket actually represents this idea of something which is very plain and very uniform. The pattern really just gives lines. It says nothing about surface or depth or any of those qualities. And all of that is 100% architecture. Anything goes, except it can't be a fabric already, and it has to be able to be manipulated by hand.
Some of the jackets have two materials that we were limited to two, but I wanted to pick one material and see how I could make something that could interact with itself and sort of self-assemble into a jacket. The jacket is a collection of almost 5,000 cast pieces of rockite. Rockite is very similar to concrete. It starts as a powdered material that you add water to. I watered mine down and used a syringe to pipe it into silicone molds, which are made all the pieces that you see here.
My jacket is made out of 6,500 linear feet of bare stranded copper wire. All of the seams are sticking out, which is why this is not ornamentation or decoration, but rather a part of the structure that's exposed.
The two materials that I picked for my jacket are thumbtacks and caulking. It's close to 13,000 tacks. You know, when you're standing far away, you don't really see what it's all made out of. And then as you get closer, you start reading different levels of information. You can see, okay, it's not chainmail, it's discs, and then, okay, the discs are actually thumbtacks.
I was really intrigued with the cassette tape, which is what I used, because it had the standardized size, it had a shiny quality, it was metallic on one side, and it became a way to generate a fabric form really quickly and still understand the structure that went along with it.
I decided to make my jacket out of penny matches and crochet mesh. I've always been very interested in this field effect.
This jacket was constructed with 12,244 erasers. Putting the pieces together was really, really challenging because the erasers didn't want to force themselves together.
My jacket is made out of 150 full ounces of zinc white heavy body acrylic paint. As the deadline is approaching, I got really stressful because nothing's like drying, so I was like freaking out.
My jacket is made of vinyl tubing and fishing wire. Putting it together physically with your hands, the fabrication process, is a great learning experience.
You can draw it 100 ways in your studio or in your office, but what matters is your understanding of how it's going to work in the field and that not everything always works out the way you think it's going to.
The material ends up doing what it needs to do, and you kind of have to accept that as well.
Architects are so used to projecting ideas and saying, you know, trying to predict outcomes. This project is not about that. There is no projecting. There is this willfulness to get the object to work.
It's just a great sense of pride that you're able to create something so delicate, so detailed, so meant to be something great, and you do it in the end, it's great.